So that first part was pretty fun, right? We just learned how to tell the difference between a non-reactive molecule, which is just inert, or a reactive molecule, which is actually going to try to make bonds with other molecules, okay? On top of that, then we also learned what type of reactivity they have, if they're going to react more like an electrophile or a nucleophile. Well, now what I want to do is I actually want to teach you guys how to start drawing out these mechanisms. So what that means is we're actually going to start drawing electron movement. And you guys are going to be probably the first people in your class to draw as good mechanisms as we're going to do now. But I'm not concerned. I know you guys are smart, and I think you guys are going to like this part. So let's go ahead and get started. So reactive molecules are the ones that are going to try to do something about their reactivity. So what that means is if you're a non-reactive molecule, you're inert. You don't care. But if you're reactive, you're going to try to share electrons with another molecule in order to become more stable. Remember that we talked about that in the first chapter, how we form molecular orbitals in order to reach a lower energy state. Okay? So it turns out that we're going to use curved arrows to indicate the direction that these electrons are going. And in organic chemistry, that's actually a huge part of this field. A huge part of this field is just figuring out where these electrons are moving to. They start here, and they move over here, and then what do they do? And then they move over here. And those are called mechanisms, okay? So I'm just going to tell you guys right now, a huge part of this course is going to be you drawing arrows and figuring out where are these electrons moving from atom to atom to atom, okay? So I just want to teach you guys or remind you guys a few things about the way that electrons move. And it turns out that these rules that I'm going to teach you are the same that we learned for resonance structures. Why? Because it turns out that resonance structures are the same thing in terms of that we're moving electrons from one atom to another. So let's go ahead and get started. So remember that arrows are always going to move from regions of high electron density to low electron density. Okay? So what that means is that we always want to start from the part of the molecule that has the most electrons and move to a part of the molecule that doesn't have a whole lot. This is the same thing that we did in resonance structures. Okay? But back when we talked about resonance structures, we didn't know about nucleophiles and electrophiles. So now that I've taught you what a nucleophile is and what an electrophile is, which one do you think is always going to be the one that starts off the arrow? Because remember, we always start from the high area, okay? So do we start off from the nucleophile or from the electrophile? And the answer is that we're going to start off from the nucleophile, okay? Because the nucleophile is the one with the negative charge, right? So we're always going to have nucleophiles that attack electrophiles, okay? And a huge part of organic chemistry can be summed up as saying nucleophiles attack electrophiles. Honestly, like when it comes down to it, you could probably explain 50% of the reactions just talking like that. Okay? So it's a very important point. Okay? So another thing is that each attacking arrow is going to represent two electrons that are being shared. So every time that I draw one of these arrows, that means that I'm sharing two electrons with another atom. And what that means is that after the reaction has taken place, I'm going to replace whatever that arrow was, I'm going to replace it with a new sigma bond. Okay? Why is that? Because remember that a sigma bond equals two electrons being shared. Okay? So what that means is that an arrow is really just a fancy way of drawing a sigma bond in motion. That means I'm creating a new sigma bond. Does that make sense so far? I know it's a lot of words, so let's just go ahead and get started. So what I want you guys to do for these reactions is, I know that you don't even know what these molecules are really, but we do understand nucleophiles and we do understand electrophiles. And we also understand how electrons move now. We kind of know. So what I want you guys to do, first of all, is determine the initial direction of electron movement by drawing the very first arrow of each mechanism. Even though we don't know what's going on here, it's okay because you can just follow the general rule of nucleophile and electrophile.